Hello friends, and thank you for taking this course, QuickBooks for Contractors. This video is a brief overview of the course, and I will show you how to do the file setup. Contractors should use most of QuickBooks the way every other business does. However, contractors have some unique challenges that are only unique to contractors that these videos are meant to address. Now, the first five videos in this series are optional, and that's because the original course material started after the setup steps and assumed the student knew basic QuickBooks. These first five videos were made after the rest of the course was made, and they were created to help students understand the basic setup of files and how it relates to the rest of the contractor's course. You still must use the preset files for video number six because there's too many details in the setup file for us to spend time on video putting in extra data. So these first five videos show you the idea, and then video number six has all the ideas that we learned, but with a lot of extra data put in. Once you start with the file for video number six, if you want, you can use the same file going forward for every video, or you could jump to a specific video and download that file so you can follow step by step for that particular video. I strongly recommend you take the course in order and watch the videos in order, but if you want to refresh your memory after taking the course, you can jump to a specific video, download that file, and follow step by step. Now, we're going to create a new company file, and I'm going to show you the most simplified steps. There are many more advanced steps that you could add when you create a company file, but they're not necessary. And you can explore and experiment with those features when you're not watching the video, but the video is meant to give only what's necessary and not what's just extra features. Now, the name of the company we will set up is Thomas Stephen Company. He's the example contractor that we will use, and we will put the file on the desktop. All you have to do is follow step by step. So, when you first open QuickBooks, either you'll have some company name up here for a company file that's already open, or you'll see what you're seeing here, no company open. It does not matter what's on the screen if you're creating a new file. If you're creating a new file, all you have to do is go to the top left and click File, New Company. Then, to make it simple, just click Express Start. The business name, Thomas Stevens Company. Now, these two fields are the only required fields in this window. All the other company information, like the business identification number or the company's address, phone number, and so on, are optional fields that you could always type in later when you come back to this window. And before I finish this video, I will show you how you can come back to this window and put in the address and name of the company so that when you print your reports, the address and the name of the company prints on the reports. For now, we're just going to choose an industry and business type. And the most simple way to do that is to click Help Me Choose, scroll to the bottom, click Other None, and then click OK. That's because we will put in our own chart of accounts instead of using the sample chart of accounts that QuickBooks gives, because there is no sample for landlords. When it comes to business type, again, click Help Me Choose, go to the bottom, click Other None, and click OK. And of course, you have the option to change this after you save the file. So we will not put in any more company information. We did everything we need, but there's one more thing we need to do. If we want to be able to choose the location of the file we are creating, we click Preview Your Setup, Preview Your Settings, and you have three tabs here in the preview settings for the file. Now you can explore and experiment with these tabs, but the one we will focus on is company file location. Now, it already says the desktop because it remembers what I like. But on your computer, you have to click change location and you have to choose the desktop. Because it's nicer if it's on the desktop, you can click it right away. So I click OK and then click OK here. Then, now that I know that my settings are correct, I will click create company. And as you can see, QuickBooks is physically creating a blank brand new company file for you to use for your contractor course. Now, when the window opens, you know, this is the setup, you can just click start working because we will do these in separate videos. So right now, just click start working. And the first thing I need to be able to show you, well, the first thing you should know is whenever these extraneous windows open, like the new feature tour or the home window, in this class, just close them out. They're not going to help you because we're going to work from the main menu and the icon bar, and those are only different ways of opening the same windows that we will open more efficiently. But if you want to be able to add your company's address and phone number so that when you print reports, it won't only have the name, it will have other company data, the way to do that is to click Company and then come down to My Company. Now, notice you put the name, but all the other information is blank because we left it blank a moment ago. Click the pencil tool here, and then we can add address, you know, 123 Sesame Street. You know, you could put the phone number, 123-456-7890, whatever you want. Then when you click OK, and then click Yes, that will be a legal address. I don't know what they want to put. 123 Sesame Street. Okay, then click OK. Now you can see that this is the information that will print on your reports when you print reports in QuickBooks.